Last year, when Bill Coleman asked if I would be a celebrity rider in his inaugural event, Pedal the Cause, I thought, great. And I was so proud to have been one of 800 riders. I had no idea that 1 month later, I would be diagnosed with stage 4 non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.
You know, hearing the words "you have cancer" is hard. Saying the words "mommy has cancer" was the hardest thing that I had ever done. The protocol called for 2.5 years of treatment. First 6 months was chemo, and the next 2 years was maintenance treatment every 3 months. And so, yeah, 2.5 years of treatment. To walk through those doors as a patient is a lot different than when you walk through as a reporter. You have a job to do and you're leaving and you're not sick. You walk through as a patient and you look at everybody differently. They're just like you, you're sick.
Leisa had one of the two most common types of non-Hodgkin lymphoma, something called follicular lymphoma, and that has been particularly challenging for us. It is a type of lymphoma that is usually responsive to therapy.
Dr. Bartlett had said, with this new treatment, 85% of the people typically go into remission.
On Monday, I had a bone marrow biopsy, and I don't know why I'm crying, because it's good news. Yesterday, Dr. Bartlett's office called and said, remission. Remission.
You ring that bell, never thinking that you'd be back, and I wish I hadn't rung that bell, I have to tell you. I would say that it was harder the second time, because you realize that you're not that one person where it doesn't come back. My cancer comes back. Dr. Bartlett said, well, there's this very exciting immunotherapy treatment, it's called ALT-803. We're trying to avoid using chemo again on you. It's a clinical trial. And she said, I believe clinical trials are the way to go. And that's really all I needed to hear. If she believed in it, okay, let's give it a shot.
So a really important part of the lymphoma program has been the relationship between the clinical lymphoma doctors like myself, who mostly see patients and try and develop new clinical trials, and our basic scientists like Todd Feniger.
Really what we do is, you know, we go in and we try to discover new ways to harness the immune system to fight cancer.
He's an immunologist as well as an oncologist, and so he understands the immune system and can help us say that, you know, this part of the immune system might be making the lymphoma grow faster, this part of the immune system might be helping to fight the lymphoma.
The type of cancer that Leisa has, it's an indolent lymphoma called follicular lymphoma. We consider this cancer highly treatable but not curable. The study that Leisa is participating in is testing a new type of immune therapy combined with sort of a tried and true old type of immune therapy. The idea that if we activate the immune system strongly, you know, could that stimulate, almost like a vaccine, her own immune system to react? And if that ends up being the case, it has the potential for curing patients. There's really been a genomic revolution where we've been able to take various types of cancer and sequence their genes and identify what's broken inside those cells. You know, we have projects where we're taking lymphomas and sequencing them, and we're taking that information and then bringing it to clinical trials. All of our research in the lymphoma group over the past, you know, 5 years or so has been supported in part by donor funds, including the Steinbeck Fund that Nancy Bartlett administers.
It really is how we got off the ground, if you will, sort of getting past just doing clinical trials and actually into sort of basic science lymphoma research. And it's really helped the coordination between Dr. Feniger and myself.
It's the research and it's the stories of people that have made it to the other side that give others hope.
She is one of those patients who has been able to have an illness that we tell her is not curable, so she knows that she's going to be living with this, and she focuses on it when she needs to, and when she doesn't need to, she is able to live her life.
When Dr. Bartlett said, "You're back in remission," I said, how do I thank you for saving my life? Not once, but twice. And she said, "You live. Go live." I'd like that.